everyone, it's Justin again. I am super excited to see you today because I've got a problem that I'm hoping you can help me out with. So my parents want to cut down a tree that's in their yard so that they can make some room for a pool. However, their town has some laws against cutting down trees that are taller than 20 feet because of their impact on the environment. The problem is, my parents don't know how tall this tree is. Now, they could hire someone to come in with fancy tools and measure how tall the tree is, but I told them I thought we could do it using geometry for free. Now, I don't know exactly how that's gonna work yet, but I am sure that there's some stuff coming up in your next unit that will help us out. In this video, we'll talk more about finding the height of my parents' tree and look at what topics will be coming up in this unit. Let's get into it. So, this tree in my parents' yard is tall. Like, taller than their house. So I don't know if it's 20 feet tall or not, but it's definitely too tall to be measured with a ladder. So we just have to figure out the height of this tree before my parents call a company in to cut it down. If it's taller than 20 feet, then they'll just say to make the pool smaller so they can keep the tree. Now, I know in our last unit, we found that we could calculate the height of tall objects by using similar triangles. However, my parents' yard's pretty small and it's completely circled by a fence. So I don't think that's gonna work here. Don't worry, I am sure that there are ways for us to calculate the height of this tree without using similar triangles. For instance, I knew that I can make a right triangle by using the tree and myself, like this, because, you know, the tree forms a right angle with the ground. I figured that we could use the Pythagorean theorem at first, because it's an equation that relates the lengths of the sides of a triangle, right? So I measured the distance between myself and the tree and found that it was 10 feet. But that's just one side. I can't measure the height of the tree, that's what we're trying to figure out. And I definitely can't measure the hypotenuse, so I guess I was stuck. I almost gave up right then. But that's when I came up with a brilliant idea. See, if I can't measure any more side lengths, then maybe I can measure the angle measurements. So my phone, like many other phones nowadays, has an app with a level on it that will tell you what angle you're holding the phone. So I line my phone up to my eye level and then line that up with the top of the tree, took a little screenshot to see what angle I was holding my phone at. And from that, I learned that this angle in the triangle right here is actually 50 degrees. But then what? I mean, I can use subtraction to find that the remaining angle is 40 degrees, but that still doesn't tell me anything about the side lengths, right? And then it hit me. Trigonometry. Trigonometry happens to be our next unit in geometry, and it's the branch of math that deals with the relationship between the angles and sides of a triangle. By the end of this unit, we will have everything we need to figure out the height of my parents' tree in this triangle. During this unit, we'll cover everything you need to know to be able to solve triangles like the one I created with my parents' tree. We'll cover special right triangles, trigonometric ratios, and their inverses using graphing calculators for trigonometry and application problems. Did you catch that I say we were going to be using graphing calculators in this unit? You are free to use a physical graphing calculator if you have one, like this one or this one. But if you don't have a physical graphing calculator, that's totally fine. There are plenty of free online options for you to use too. When the time comes, I will teach you how to use either a physical graphing calculator or the online one provided by GeoGebra. Of course, as always, you will have your trusty notes template PDF to help you out in this unit. It's filled with guided notes, exploration activities, and plenty of challenge opportunities for you to earn some bonus gold. Trigonometry is a topic that's gonna come up a lot in future math courses. So you're gonna wanna make sure that you have super good notes for you to reference later when you need them. All right, it's time to get started. I am super excited for you to come back here at the end of the unit so we can calculate my parents' tree. And you've got yourself a really cool activity in your notes template coming up. I don't want to give you any spoilers, but let's say you might want to take out your spyglass, matey. Good luck, and I will see you next time.